Norton as an artist was visionary. I think she was unique because she was inspired not only by the techniques, the materials, and what she learned about creating her work, but the people she knew, where she traveled, where she came from. It all comes together with a very spiritual quality that connects landscape, nature, and art. It was 2 years before Ann passed away that she decided she wanted to create a legacy for this community, a place that created a sanctuary for enjoyment by visitors from all over the world.
Well, the gardens is a bit of a mystery tour, which is really wonderful, so that people can really feel when they go into the gardens that they've gone into a magical tropical jungle in a way. There are ponds, there are Ann's 9 major monumental sculptures that are in place, and there are 4 to 5 galleries inside the house in the rooms. It is a large collection of rare species of palms and of other tropical plants. In fact, one of the largest in the country. So people can explore, and we have taken the time to label a lot of the trees. It's an educational experience as well as a pleasurable one. A number of her sculptures were made of plaster, a lot of them in fact, but there are some bronzes as well, and of course the wood. When we come to her sketches, she worked a lot in charcoal and in pastel, and in the house we do show some of her sketches that were kind of pre-sketches to her work, to her sculptures, and she used a lot of color, and she worked in some very interesting materials. As we've said, she was a lover of nature, and she took the best materials from nature that she thought would be appropriate for her work. And as you will see, the northern cedar that she uses reflects also some of the Native American totems. Those materials were used, that kind of wood was used for that. She's very spiritual about her work, and she would take these kinds of materials that complement the ideas that lie behind the subject matter that she chose to create.
We're standing in front of Gateway No. 1, which is so symbolic of what Ann wanted to communicate with her work. She called this the window to the soul.
See here is the influences that Ann Norton had, the Eastern influences, the spiritual influences. We think there is some Mayan influence here too, and also the influences of her mind. In 1977, the house was opened to the public. It became registered on the National Register of Historic Places. And since then, every effort has been made to include the community and to educate. Thousands of school children come through these doors and through the gardens every year. And that's a very, very important part of the legacy that Ann left. The Ann Norton Sculpture Gardens and Ann Norton herself is something of a treasure here in West Palm Beach. And in South Florida, it is rare to find a house, a studio where the artist lived and worked, and where her work still is in position here today.
Ann made a remarkable contribution to the world of modern art. And her vision and legacy here reflect so much of her interest in travel, the exploration of Eastern philosophy, the very intuitive spiritual qualities that she enjoyed.